I'm actually going to start this video by stabbing Wilson in the back, like literally, because I wanted this intro. Look how happy Wilson is, because he's with me in my German workshop at Siegfried's Mechanical Music Cabinet, where I'm going to build a prototype to try if a heavy flywheel can play tight music. I've been designing and working on my theoretical skills, and it's time to do some practical building. And I'm recording this on August 1st, and you're gonna watch the video on August 1st, because me and Hannes are going to try to make one video every day to show you the building progress. These are the 6 flywheel plates. We've been discussing a lot on how to attach a flywheel to a shaft like this. And I got great feedback from my application engineer at SKF to use a tapered bushing. So we're gonna machine this ID to fit perfectly with this tapered bushing. The shaft goes in like so, a real nice fit. And when you tighten these screws down, everything should be awesome. And then for bearings, we're using another super nice suggestion from SKF. These are bearing housings with a cam lock. So it has a taper in it. When I insert this cam lock, boop. So I can tighten this and the whole bearing will clamp around the shaft like this. So that is an awesome solution. Here's the transmission belt and some pulleys, some more SKF stuff, some more plates for a governor, and a pedal link. So we're gonna get to all these parts later in the week. And look who has just entered the chat. Sir3.5K with legs. So these are laser cuts with all the features in them. So I'm gonna weld together this whole frame later. I've actually done some safety measure. I've removed the battery here from my angle grinder. So this machine will not be used this week. It's my hope anyway. Let's see how that goes. Already the first fit I'm a little bit nervous about, because this taper bushing should go into the middle here. I made it 1 millimeter smaller than the OD of this in CAD, but it looks kind of big. Perhaps I got the very first thing wrong. Let's look at that. So my plan here is to design the ID of the flywheel plate undersized and then put it on the lathe and machine it to the perfect dimension to fit this tapered bushing. This tapered bushing can expand in the OD and the ID, which makes it such a perfect way to secure the flywheel plates to the shaft. However, it's going in already. Why is that? So the tapered bushing is perfectly 42, and the ID of this, I wonder what happened here. So perhaps what I need to do is that I need to build this ID up with some welds. That was not how I planned to start this day, because I found out my stupid mistake. Isn't this funny, you all? First measurement, and I already screwed up. But I'm happy because I actually didn't miscalculate the tolerances. It's just a basic CAD error. So let me just show you what went wrong here. So the ID of this ring is 41 millimeter. First I revolved the disc like this, and then I cut these holes from the side with the next feature here. And for some stupid reason, I had a 42 millimeter ring left, and I cut out the 42 millimeter ring in this feature. So what I should have simply done is that I should have deselected this ring, press OK, and the part would have been the correct size. So actually, I'm much happier that I made this kind of mistake. I didn't miscalculate the tolerances. First thing wrong. How much confidence do you feel at home right now in this prototype? I will have to win you over during the week. Sun is shining. I can do the welding helmet trick again. Did some mistakes, but I'm fixing them. Life is good. Let's see if I remember how to weld. Okay, that's a little bit too hot. I said I wasn't going to use the angle grinder, but this is polishing. It doesn't really count, does it? So the hole is now filled in, and the taper bushing doesn't fit, and we can cut a perfect opening with the lathe instead. Now I need to do this 6 times. Three down, three to go. Can't believe I gave me this shit job to begin with. Anyway, we're getting it fixed. Don't you worry about a thing. I have the macro lens. Can we find the biceps, perhaps? Oh my god! Not super pretty, but the prettiest weld so far. It worked much better when I started inside and then added the corner on top of the inside material. So on the fifth try, I got it right. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna put these three together and these three together. So for that, we need some M8 bolts, and I have all my bolts over here. So there's the old machine, and in this shelf is all my bolts from France. If you saw the videos where I was living in France, that's very recognizable, as well with Marius here. M8 hex 40. Here's the lock nuts, and yes, M8 lock nuts. I hope I made these holes big enough for the bolts. Perfect. Okay, I have two half flywheels ready for lathing. These are super heavy already. So one and two. And now I'm gonna prepare the pulley. And these are the parts for the pulley. And with these parts, I didn't make the CAD mistake. So the pulley should be just like a Lego kit. So let's see if we can put that together. The pulley is a simple sandwich, starting with a flange. And then we have an inner piece. I need to line up these strange moon holes here. So there, all the moon holes are lining up. And then I have a 2mm spacer plate. Another 10mm disc, and then the outer flange. So this pulley really don't need to be solid metal, but I tried comparing prices by cutting this in smaller section and welding it together, and that was much more expensive. It does way too much. For the prototype, this is going to work awesome. This part took me 5 minutes to put together and was really like a Lego kit. So let's see with my power transmission belt how that fits. So from five solid metal parts, I have the flange and everything. And here comes the belt, and it just goes in perfect. Here's how the ID looks when you mess up your CAD. And here's how the ID looks when you don't mess up your CAD. All in all, I'm using 5 tapered bushings in the prototype. So one here, and one here. And these 3 parts are prepared. However, we have those 2 small parts here to prepare for lathing as well. And on these small parts, I also did a correct ID. So currently, I can't get the tapered bushing in here. And this part is going to be welded together before lathing. So let's do that right now. I have designed this little step right here to know exactly where this should go. So there's no measuring involved. Just have to put them on there, and that should be a good position. All the welding on this part is done. It's ready for lathing. This one took 5 minutes. This one took half an hour. These two took the rest of the day because of my mistake with the ID. All the parts are now prepared for lathing, and tomorrow we're gonna lathe inside here in the metal workshop. And we have a small lathe here, which we're gonna do all the small parts on. Then over here we have the big one. So we're gonna put the parts in somewhere here, like that. And I don't know how to lathe,
So there's actually someone coming in tomorrow to teach me.
Before we finish this day, I actually want to take a sneak peek of the fit of the frame. I'm super curious if my CAD is actually correct. So down here on the ground, we have the frame parts. So I spent a lot of time in CAD thinking about how to put these parts together. And I'm very curious to see if I actually did it correctly. Let's take this one and this one and we'll find out. So on some parts I have these puzzle pieces and in some parts I have the corresponding holes. And it was a big question about how big I should make these holes, how much tolerance I need for everything to fit perfectly. And I canceled the whole order because I wanted to make these holes larger. So if they don't fit now, if I have to angle grind this down, I'm going to be very disappointed. Yes. Perfect. Yes. It's the same here. Perfect. When I weld this together, I don't have to measure or anything. I just know where all the parts should go. So it's 4 o'clock now. You will see this video in about 2 hours on August 1st. And this is the first day. And for a first day, I'm pretty happy. I've been looking a lot for tools and finding my way around this brand new workshop. So we still got pretty much done. First thing tomorrow morning, I'm gonna weld the entire frame together, I hope. And then later, I get help with the lathing. So yeah, that's it for our first day. Sir3K, do you wanna wave goodbye? Marius, you wanna wave goodbye? See you tomorrow for part 2. Thanks for watching. Ciao.